Don't worry about the oncoming traffic. Just go ahead and turn left. It's the hot new fad in traffic engineering, guaranteed to save time. Just not like this. There's a more formal process to it.
A traffic light's sort of like eating a pie. Let me explain.
All traffic lights have phases, you know, the directions that the cars go so they don't crash into each other. A really simple stoplight would just have two phases, one street and then the other. But when you get into busier streets, you need protected left turns, and it gets more complicated. And the more slices of pie you chop the pie into, the reduced probability that you're going to end up with a green light.
So what do you do if a whole bunch of traffic shows up, and pretty soon there isn't enough time to get all the cars through on the green? You can make the one direction have a longer green, but that means a longer red for the other direction. For years, traffic engineers have cheated the system by making double left turns and triple through lanes. These help because you get more cars through in about the same amount of time, but sometimes you run out of space. First, let's talk about a regular intersection. You can get a green arrow and go straight and left, and well, now the traffic the other way, it has to turn left too, and now you have the cross street, it has to make its left turn and be able to go straight. This is one of the traditional layouts you'll see all over the country, and it's a four-phase signal. But what if there's just not enough time to get everybody through in a four-phase signal? Introducing the continuous flow intersection. This clever design was pioneered, I believe, down in Mexico City, probably about 15 or 20 years ago. You take the cars that want to turn left at the intersection and make them get in a special bay far before the intersection. You start to let the traffic that wants to turn left on the main street over into this little displaced left turn bay off to the side. Now that they're out of the way, when the street gets its green again, the left turn people can turn at the same time. Plus, as an added bonus, you can add these handy dandy free right turn things. And now that there's just three phases, each of the slices of the pie can be a little bit bigger.
How much that improvement is will vary depending on the situation, but just using napkin math, I'd say it goes from maybe getting a 30% chance of a green light on the main street to 50% or more.
Now, of course, there's a catch. There always is in traffic engineering. How on earth is a pedestrian supposed to cross 9 lanes of traffic? That is a good question. They just don't let people cross the street. So you gotta go buy a car. No, they put in a tunnel. That way people can cross under the street. That's a very expensive way to solve the problem. And that's something planners might want to think about before they just start rolling these out and say, old lady in a wheelchair, good luck crossing.
So there's like 17 of these across the United States. Half of those are in my home state of Utah, where they worked really well. Federal Highway Administration says one of them reduced CO2 emissions by like 20 tons. Another one cut fuel by almost 1 million gallons a year. Talking with my friends and neighbors about their impressions of driving these, they think they're really weird. There's a lot of alternative intersection and interchange design that planners are using and engineers are using that a lot of people like. In a future video, I'll talk about the diverging diamond interchange, and a lot of people really like that one. But these, I've never really come across anybody who likes them, and most people don't even understand. They think it's just weird for the sake of weird, and I don't think they think through that benefit of having the left turns turn at the same time as people going straight. And so as a result, I don't know if these are really appropriate for every situation. I think these really are kind of a band-aid on major expressway-type roads that really need a bridge and a freeway off-ramp. But because bridges and freeway off-ramps are very expensive to build, these can kind of buy some time to keep traffic moving in a cost-effective way while the state saves up its pennies, nickels, and dimes until it's finally ready to build something beefy and permanent. And that's actually exactly what happened in Utah. Utah's removed more CFIs than your state has probably ever built. It's not to say the state doesn't like CFIs. It's just it was on a highway called Bangor Highway. The CFIs were a band-aid to buy some time, and now that the state has the money, they're turning Bangor Highway into a freeway and getting rid of these. So they served their purpose, but it wasn't really ever a permanent fix.
I'm here to talk traffic. Anything else you have a question about of how roads work? I'll look it up and do a future video. Leave that in the comments below. Don't forget to hit subscribe. And of course, as always, thank you for watching.